we as coaches got the wrong idea right now. I got two kids coming in to work out tomorrow, and the coach didn't want them to come. Except because he thinks he's going to lose them to go to the pros. And if he comes to work out with me, he'll get a taste of playing at the pros and want to come out. So the coach called me and said, we don't want him to work out. We just want him to do individual work. And we don't want him to get hurt. And I got tickled because I've never been a coach about wins, loss, wins. I've been a coach about development. That's probably why I've been fired twice as a head coach in the NBA. Because when you're about development, you're about what Coach Rich development of the whole character. Okay, so I'll never forget when I suspended Dennis Rodman, and I thought I was doing the right thing as a pro coach. And my general manager said to me, hey, look, we're not in the rehab business. We're in the winter business. Give him a fine and keep on moving. And I left a team where we won 62 games. I didn't leave. Popovich came, and I was really pissed off because I was in coaching for the wrong reason. I was more in coaching because of my suits, trying to wear a different suit every night, look like Pat Riley, coach. And I was the first coach to coach who had never gone up as anybody's assistant, never been in junior high school. I came from playing right to the head coach. It wasn't Jason Kidd, it was me. And I had a great team, and I thought I was the reason we won. Until I went to Philadelphia. And in San Antonio, I had David Robinson, Dennis Rodman, Sean Elliott, Avery Johnson. Shit, we were good. I went to Philadelphia, and I had Sean Bradley, Clarence Weatherspoon, C.J. Tyler. We were really bad. And I went from winning 60 games to losing 60. And what I learned was, you got to have talent to win. Now, I'm going to talk to you about developing pros. Changed my whole concept. And the reason I'm upset with coaches is coaches are telling all these kids they can be pros. You know how hard it is to be a pro. My gym is set up for 7 a.m. in the morning. I don't want people to come. It's set up at 7 a.m. for a reason. Don't come. And then when we set up at 7 a.m., we're going to run. We're going to play one-on-one. We're going to see where your skill is. We're going to work on your weekend. And I cut. And people say, well, why do you cut? Tell you why I cut. Because when a guy makes $84 million, he's going to cut your ass. And see, Coach Green in high school coaching, shut up! Okay. But I don't want you to talk. Tell Steve Francis to shut up. You shut the fuck up. Now, you got to be able to deflect that and come back and hold your breath. Because the one thing about people who are really good, they know just as much as you do. They think they do. So if I was developing a pro player now, the first thing I would do is meet with his family, whether it's a single mom. And the first thing I tell her, I ain't screwing you. I don't want a relationship with you. I just want to help your kid get better. First thing I tell her. Second thing, if he's a dad, I'm going to tell him, what do you do? I work at FedEx. I do that. I would never come to FedEx and try to tell you how to ship a package. So don't come in my gym trying to tell me how we're going to coach. Sounds simple, but the better that kid gets, the harder it is for that dad to get out the way. And the reason it's hard is everybody wants to taste what full life is all about. And I tell all kids, it looks easy when you're, and there's a lot of guys in the pros now. They're not pros. My son's one of them. He's in the pros, but he's in the pro. Because see, now the draft is not set up to get pros. The draft is set up to draft somebody young enough to find out if he's good enough before we pay him any money. See, when I came out of school, you were taking a junior or a senior. Coach made a good point. JV till JV got the ball. So if I took John Wall as a freshman out of Kentucky. And he's the number one pick. I'm going to get beat all night. First of all, he can't command the locker room of 30-year-old people with three kids. Second thing is I drafted him to take him to see if he's going to be good, because guess what happens the next year? Another draft. Now, we get a four-year contract, and I'll explain the rest of it. But only 2 years of the first round is guaranteed. If you look at the draft, less than 13% of all lottery picks in the last 20 years are even in the league now. It ain't in the league. 7 a.m. Talk to the brother. Tell the dad to stay out of the way. And the next person we got to address is that narcissistic kid that's got the chance to be good. Stop getting relationships with him. Either be the coach or be the friend. You can't be the coach and the friend and the guy to get the shoes and to go do this. You ain't the guy no more. It's like coaching tennis. If the person you training pays you, you ain't the boss. That's the boss. I argued with Tom Izzo almost, you're going to be mad at me, almost took the Minnesota Timberwolves yard. Because Flip, that Hopkins, and Tom's itching to go up there. And I said, well, okay, if you go, just understand you won't be able to put mitts on and be hitting people going through that. All of a sudden, you know, you ain't the boss. You got to get along. They're going to pay you about $4 million, but the salary cap's going to be $70 million. Who's going to get fired? So all of you young aspiring coaches that want to coach on that pro level, understand you got to get along with, and then now, you're not the boss. They're going to tell you who's on your team, who going to play, how much you're going to play. But when you develop in a pro, you get the perks, you get them, now you got the kid. Now you separate yourself and you do one thing, coach. You can't keep him because I don't close my gym. And the reason I don't close my gym, I got drug dealers in the gym. I know who in my gym. I do it purposely. Because that's what the NBA lifestyle is all about. So I got to see how you handle who y'all. Now act like I ain't watching, but I watch who you cultivate to. Real simple. Then I watch what you do when you're not with me. I don't want to hold your whole life. I just want your basketball life. Now, 7 a.m., 7 days a week. 500 made shots a day. Dribble work. I take a tennis lesson and put it into an hour and a half of basketball in the morning. Now it's 7 o'clock. Now it's some weekends. And the reason it's 7 a.m. on the weekends is because I know what Friday night's like. Anybody that's going out in Houston, the king of strip clubs, and you can't show up at Saturday morning, you ain't the pro I'm looking for. Saturday and Sunday, 7 a.m. It's hard getting my staff in. Really, the Sabbath. They don't want to work 7 days. You're not the guy for me. I eat, sleep, and live basketball. You know what I want so bad? And I know Wes is here from Dallas. I'm Snoop. I want the number one pick in the draft to come from Houston, Texas before I die. That's my goal. I can't get to him. Everybody else got him. And everybody else telling them what Alan Branch tells them all the time. You're a pro, and I can get you. How are you going to get somebody that ain't never been there? We've had so much talent that's gotten destroyed in this city because we just don't want to get the fuck out the way. as close as me. I ain't trying to, look, I have a son. Two of them. Both of them knee high to a duck, maybe about the loud side. One in the pros, is a third guard at best, shoots way too much, can't go left, can't guard a soul. I know exactly what, but you know why he's a pro? He loves being a pro. He the first guy to throw the pros the ball. When they come off the bench, he's the first guy up, clap. They pay him $5 million not to come and bother nobody. $5 million, you shut the fuck up. Never have nobody come ask when to play, how much you're going to play. Just be quiet, and we're going to give you this money. Wow. That's first thing. Second thing, the draft comes up, and you get ready to go to the draft. And I'm going to use Wes's son. Shoot the ball lights out. I've seen everybody shoot the ball left and right lights out. If he comes and gets in the draft in a year and says, I'm going to show him I can play defense, and I can show him, man. And I ain't drafting. It's what you did that got you here. It's what I'm looking for. Don't try to show me something you can't do now to improve your stuff. I'm still here today. What got you to the point to get drafted was that you can shoot. Name me how many pros do everything. Okay, how many pros do everything? None. How many are going right on 99% of them?
Coach, you trying to say LeBron?
No. And we're going to get on your Tim Duncan thing. the other part that white guys miss about the game is the game's different. High school is about teaching fundamentally and whether you get caught up with a coach that's going to try to say, X school won 9 state championships, ain't nobody go to college. They ain't a coach. He coaching for the school. He coaching for his job. But now, we lost 900 games, and all the kids in college. That's my man. Second, college is different than the pros. The rules are different, which make it a different game right off the bat. In college, it's 20 hours a week to work with a player. Now, I hired Europe, and I've been watching him work doing skill work. Okay? All college. Now, I want all y'all raise your hand who teach both pivot feet. Get your hands up. Some of the dumbest shit I've ever seen. I'm talking about, I've ever seen Dwight Howard get it and turn this way and can't shoot the ball. Wrong pivot foot. Miles Turner, same thing, wrong pivot foot. Now I got to look at it, when I draft that guy, how much teaching do I have to do? So